Costas, thank you.
Hi, I'm Costas, the second Costas Association. I'm going to talk to you about the simulation infrastructure we built in the EU project Cloud Lighting. The purpose of this simulation is to demonstrate the efficiency and scalability of the self-organization and self-management system that John discussed before. So regarding my presentation, we are going to have a short introduction, talk some stuff about simulation, and then some design decisions we took for developing our simulation, and then some conclusions. Of course, the work on implementing the simulator is still ongoing, but the core engine is developed. We have some validation processes on the models we have developed, and then measure some results in order to show the efficiency of our frame. As you probably know, cloud environments are getting more and more popular nowadays. By the year 2020, it is expected that about 92% of the total workload will be executed on the cloud, and additionally about 50% of all data centers will be hardware scale data centers. Nowadays, about 1.5 million data centers from the three major cloud providers are hyperscale. The traditional cloud environments are usually their architecture is based on warehouse scale computing, and recently many vendors are trying to integrate heterogeneous hardware, namely hardware accelerators. For example, GPUs, many integrated cores, and FPGAs. This addition will bring some potential problems because it will increase the complexity of monitoring the hardware, provisioning or developing the appropriate software for running on this heterogeneous cloud infrastructures. So this is an image showing how warehouse scale computing is, the part of the warehouse scale computing is. We have a general core switch, in the second layer some aggregation switches, and in the last level we have the racks of the homogeneous hardware resources. Some cons of the cloud environments with the commodity servers are, as other speakers discussed before, the over-provisioning, underutilization of hardware resources, some management issues that may arise due to heterogeneity, and some organization issues, mostly because users requirements does not match with what they really get from the cloud as hardware. Most of these problems, we think that these problems will be tackled by using this self-organization and self-management system. In order to evaluate how this system will behave on large scale, we developed a simulation framework. There are a lot of open source cloud simulators. Most of them are discrete event simulators, but they have to meet some criteria in order to give us some valuable results on scale. They should be able to handle a very large amount of computations, and they should provide accurate models for power consumption of the hardware. They should have been designed natively parallel in order to run on distributed systems and to scale up as much as possible. The tasks can span among
multiple virtual machines. They should have the support for the hardware accelerators, and ideally the simulator should be built in a programming language that is actually built for high performance computation classes, C++. Regarding our developed framework, we borrow the design from large-scale engineering and physics simulations. That means that we have a time advancing loop. To be more specific, the time advances from time T0 equals to zero with a predefined time step. This way of designing and running the simulation allows us to integrate dynamic components such as the social system that UCC proposes. And by playing with the time step, we can have a coarse or a fine-grained picture of how the system behaves during the time. This is an abstract cloud architecture. One cell above, we have a gateway cell that is responsible for creating the tasks and send them to the cells in order to be executed on the hardware. Each cell, here we have only one cell, each cell consists of a broker that is responsible for retrieving the tasks from the gateway service and assign the hardware that is going to actually execute the tasks. We also have some network and storage components that measure the utilization of network and the storage of its application. Here you can see a generalized driver for our simulation. The first step is to initialize all our parameters, then have the time advancing loop from zero to a predefined maximum, let's say, time, or when all the tasks are allocated on the hardware. Then the first thing is to create a task queue in the gateway service. We send the task to the broker. The broker receives the tasks from the gateway service and assign these tasks to the hardware. And then we perform. Thank you. And then we perform some updates on our statistics engine in order to get some measurements, for example, on the utilization of the hardware. We use a hybrid parallelization for the simulation. It's a combination of a distributed memory system and a set memory system. I think I have a the gateway service is considered to be the head node of our system that's responsible, as we said before, for creating tasks and send them through MPI communication functions to the rest of the cells of our system. Each cell is actually a multi-core node that with the use of OpenMP can run faster by utilizing the many cores that the system has in order to accelerate the processing of the task allocation. The MPI communications are actually really low. They do not affect very much the performance of our simulation, since we only set a few things. The number of virtual machines, the number of virtual CPUs per virtual machine, memory, storage, and network bandwidth. So these are actually sent really fast. The computational intensive part of our simulation is the search for the adequate hardware resources so that this task can be assigned to a specific hardware, into a server. And for this reason, we use, as we said before, OpenMT in order to accelerate this process. A more detailed driver from point 3 to point 6 is it's actually the tasks that the head node, the gateway service, runs, and the rest of the tasks are what its cell does. And of course, we need to have a synchronization, an MPI synchronization at the end, in order to synchronize all the distributed processes in order to get to the next time step. We have developed, we have actually inspired from other simulators some power models for describing the power consumption of CPU servers. And for this reason, we use some functions already developed in other frameworks. These are some linear functions. It's this one, or we use some interpolation models, visualized interpolation models, when we have some data available, manufacturer data we have available from some vendors. We also proposed some other interpolation models and some other functions, but we still need to validate them through some real results in order to be sure that they will be accurate. We have also created some power models for the accelerators, actually some functions that depend on the utilization of its accelerator. This can be seen in this function. Regarding the execution model, most frameworks use space set or time set models for execution. We propose the space time set model because it is what actually a modern operating system uses nowadays. As said before, we have used MPI together with OpenMP for parallelization on top of C++ programming language. We have tried to use as less libraries, external libraries as possible in order to be compliant with high performance clusters and compilers they may have. This is actually a better overview of what we try to do. So you see here the MPI communication between the head node and the slaves, let's say. And within each slave, we use OpenMP in order to run some tasks within its node. We have tried to create this framework as extensible as possible. For example, if someone wants to test a new power model for a hardware, he can just adding some code into a specific C++ class, and then can test how his system will behave. And of course, if someone wants to have to add a different kind of broker, such as the source system, what he needs to do is only just play with only a class of our developed system. And some conclusions. We have proposed a hybrid parallel framework for simulation of hyperscale cloud simulations. This framework, at least we try to be as accessible as possible. So if someone wants to add something, he can do it with small additions and less effort as possible. We have proposed some power consumption models that we expect to be more accurate, but I cannot tell at the moment they are accurate because I don't have the results yet. And we have also created some execution and power consumption models for the hardware accelerators. We have tested the simulation on the simulator on some HPC cluster, only to check the scalability at the moment. And we have seen some very good results, for example, running in 10 million hardware nodes, simulated nodes. Took us about 1.5 hours, if I remember correctly. But this is only regarding the scalability. Regarding the effectiveness, we have to wait to validate some models and do more research. I try to be as fast as possible.
Thank you very much, Professor. Thank you. Gave us an interesting figure at the end there, Costas. 10 million nodes you can simulate in 1.5 hours,
something? Yeah.
And what exactly are you simulating in that 1.5 hours?
We will create artificial tasks as many as possible in this time step, and we try to allocate them to the hardware infrastructure. So the hardware infrastructure consists of 10 million heterogeneous nodes, and then we try to allocate as much tasks as possible within the hardware. But of course, the work is still ongoing, so we may have a better result.
Any other questions?
Very, very good question. So, could you see a system, sort of hybrid system, where you would have cells that are using time step simulations, and others that are using simulation or statistical models, so that you don't care too much about some data centers, but one of them is very important. We simulate this one with a high accuracy and the other ones with less. If that makes any sense.
I don't actually get your question.
Okay, so maybe
take it off line. Okay. Can I just finish by thanking all the speakers, process and process. I mean, but I'm the one who kept everybody late.